This week on Ask the Meadmaker, I'm drinking a beer because never let it be said that Ricky the Meadmaker isn't ecumenical. Welcome to Ask the Meadmaker, where I, Ricky the Meadmaker, answer your questions about mead making, mead drinking, mead brewing, and really, any question you're willing to send to me. The first question this week is about force carbonation in mead. People want to make a mead which is sparkling or bubbly or carbonated, and they don't want to have to use the yeast. Basically, they want to know, how do you push CO2 bubbles into your mead? The answer is, the easiest way to do it is in a keg. If you try to force carbonate in bottles, there are these really weird, complicated contraptions that do it. But basically, force carbonation is nothing more complicated than putting your mead in a keg, putting that keg on CO2 at the desired PSI you want, and waiting. I've gotten a lot of questions recently about overfeeding, which I initially took as an insult, and then I realized people weren't asking about me, they were talking about yeast nutrient. People want to know, can you overfeed your yeast? And the answer is, in one sense, no. Put in all the nutrient you want, your yeast will only uptake so much of that nutrient, however much they need. It's like putting a plate of food in front of a toddler. Toddler will eat until she is full and leave the rest. But here's the problem. The yeast will also leave the rest, which means you will have nutrient potentially settling out of solution, precipitating to the bottom, and then you'll have weird sort of zinc metal flavors left over in your mead. As many of you know, I consult pro bono with startup meaderies. The reason I do this is because I'd love to see more meaderies in America and around the world. And one question I always get from budding professional mead makers is this as big a leap as it seems, going from being a home brewer to being a professional brewer? And the answer is, it's a much larger leap than it seems like. In addition to being an ecumenical drinker, let it never be said that I am too big to admit my mistakes. I'm just too big to buy clothing at a normal store. Last episode, the tree underneath of which I was seated was identified as a butternut. It is not a butternut tree. It is in fact a northern catalpa tree. Thank you, Mark, an agronomist from Iowa, for pointing out my mistake. Sven from Iceland has brewed his first mead. Congratulations, but he has a problem. He started with this massive original gravity and ended up with something very, very low. Very high alcohol, but he says it's light and watery and has the mouthfeel of a lager. And he wanted something thick and syrupy. Well, there's an easy solution to this. Sorbate it so it doesn't re-ferment and add more honey. Before I send it over to Ricky with our word of the week, I need your help. I've been getting lots and lots of questions recently about fermenting with fruit. Fresh, concentrate, juices, and dried. People want to know what's the difference between fermenting with a dried fruit and a fresh fruit. And frankly, I don't have time right now to run side-by-side experiments. But you guys do. Over the next few months, I would love if you could write to me with your experiments. Do you use a concentrate versus a juice? Do you use fresh and chop it up? Do you use fresh and drop it in whole? How do you ferment with fruit? And in a few months, we'll do a whole episode on the subject. That's our last question for the week. And it's weird, it's a question for you guys. I just need to send it over to Ricky with our word of the week. Ricky?
Thank you, Ricky. You caught me just in time. I was off for a gentlemanly game of croquet. This week's word is hydrolysis. Hydrolysis is the process of adding water to break apart a compound. When you break apart sugars, it's called saccharification, and it is an essential component of making mead. When you mix your water and your honey together, there is some level of saccharification or hydrolysis. So if you want to sound even more pretentious, tell people that you've just hit the hydrolysis point of your brew day. Hydrolysis, it's our word of the week and the end of our show. Keep sending your questions and I'll get to them as soon as possible. Cheers.